Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Friends, today we are going to learn a concept that is weighted average cost of capital. The most important thing for calculating or for valuation purpose. Without WACC, you cannot discount any cash flow. And for calculating the discounted cash flows, you need WACC, that is your weighted average cost of capital. For any valuation method, you will need a WACC to calculate for discounting, for getting the present value of the cash flows. WACC is the weighted average cost of capital of the company's debt and the cost of equity. We are talking about both the thing. Weighted average cost of capital analysis assumes that the capital markets, both over here we are talking about debt and equity, in any given industry requires return commensurate with the perceived riskiness of their investment. But does WACC help the investors to decide whether to invest into a company or not? Well, we'll discuss in this tutorial. To understand weighted average cost of capital, let's take a very simple example. Suppose you want to start a small business. You go to the bank and you ask that you need a loan. Let's say you ask for a loan to start off. Bank looks at your business plan and tells you that it will lend you the loan. But there's only one thing that you need to do. Bank says that you need to pay 10% interest. Okay, so this is your KD, cost of debt, over and above the principal amount that you are borrowing. So you agree and the bank lends you the loan. Okay, now to avail the loan, you agreed to pay a fee, that is you paid some interest expense, and this fee is the cost of capital in simple terms, that is the 10%. So as business needs a lot of money to invest in the expansion of its production process, they need a source of money. The source money from their shareholders in the form of initial public offer, IPO, that I'm talking about, and they also take the loan from the banks and institutions. So for having the large sum of money, company needs to pay the cost, and we call this as the cost of capital, which is called as WACC. Now, if a firm has more than one source where they take funds from, we need to take a weighted average cost of capital. Now, how relevant is WACC? See, it's basically the internal calculation, okay? And you can say that when investors evaluate investing into a business or a firm, they calculate the WACC. And for example, let's say, you know, investor A wants to invest in company X, okay? Investor A wants to invest in company X, and now A sees that the weighted average cost of capital of company X is, let's say, 10%, okay, and the return on the capital at the end of the period is 9%. Okay, the return is basically 9%. The return on the capital of 9% is lower than the WACC. As you can see, return is 9 and WACC is 10%. So A decides against investing in the company X, as the value he will get after investing into company is less than the weighted average cost of capital. So what is the formula? See, many investors don't calculate the WACC because it's little complex than the other financial ratio. But if you are one of those who would like to know how WACC works, this is the formula. WACC is equal to your equity. Okay, your equity divide by the total equity plus debt. Okay, this whole will be multiplied into your KE, that is the cost of equity. You will add something that is called debt. So this is percentage of debt divided by equity plus debt, and the same you will multiply with the cost of debt, and cost of debt is always post tax. So 1 minus the tax rate. Once you do this, you get your amount of, or you get a percentage of WACC. Now, market value of the equity. Let's start with the E. Okay. The market value of the equity, how should we calculate it? See, let's say there's a company A that has some outstanding shares of, 10,000. And the market price of each of the share at this moment is 10, which is your P0. So the market value of the equity would be 1000 into 10. This is the market value of the equity today. sorry, this is, let's say, 10,000 shares. Okay. Now, the market value of the equity can also be termed as the market cap. This is called as market cap. Investors can know where to invest their money and where they shouldn't. The next is the market value of the debt. Okay. That is the, now let's understand the meaning of the market value of the debt. That is, we are talking about D over here. How to calculate? See, it's difficult to calculate the market value of the debt because very, very, very few firms have their debt in the form of outstanding bonds in the market. So if the bonds are listed, we can directly take the listed price as the market value of the debt. Now, let's go back to the WACC. Okay, let's not drift. WACC and look at V, the total market value of the equity and debt. So it's self-explanatory. We just need to add the market value of the equity and the estimated market value of the debt. And that's it. We have the answer. Now, there's another thing that is called cost of equity. Now, to quickly understand this, cost of equity is basically your KE, which is found out as per the KPAM model. And here's the formula of the KPAM model. KPAM is equal to RF into beta, which is the sensitivity of the stock to the market, into risk premium, that is your return from the market less the risk-free rate. So here beta is the regression of the company's stock price. The cost of debt, that is your KD, is equal to the interest, that is the cost of debt is the risk-free rate, that is your RF, plus the credit spread, okay, into your 1 minus tax, because it will be always post-tax, so 1 minus T. And your credit spread depends upon the credit rating. Better credit rating will decrease the credit spread, and vice versa the case. So this is how the whole thing is found out. Let's take one formula. Let's say there is a company A and there's company B. Let's say company A has a cost of, let's say it, the risk-free rate will remain the same for all, 10% and 10%, let's say. The RM risk from the market is over here 12% and over here, let's say 11%. And the beta of the stock over here is 1.2 and here 2.1. This is highly risky. So the cost of equity in this case, we are trying to calculate WACC over here. Okay. The cost of equity is going to be RF plus your beta into bracket RM minus RF. Okay. So 12.4 over here is KPAM, and just carry forward it over here. You will see 12.4 and 12.1. Okay. Is your calculation for cost of equity. In the similar fashion, let's say company has taken some debt, and let's say the debt is close enough to $1 million over here and $1.5 million over here, and the interest, let's say over here, is let's say 10%, and over here as 12%. The tax rate remains same for both, let's say 30%, and over here 30%. Control R. So once we do that, we can calculate the cost of debt, that is the amount of the debt into the percentage, into 1 minus the tax rate. Okay, so that will give us our cost of debt finally. So KD, this is the amount of the interest. Once you divide the amount of interest divided by the cost, you will get the cost of debt, and press Control R. So this is exactly your KD. So this is the debt, amount of debt, and we need equity. So if the amount of equity is, let's say over here 1 million and over here 2 million, so just try and evaluate the thing with the help of WACC. What we are supposed to do, equity is equal to equity, just form the bracket, divide by your equity plus debt into your cost of equity, which is we just found over here 12.4, right, plus your amount of debt, open another bracket, debt, divide by over here bracket equity plus debt, okay, into your cost of debt, 7%. That's it. 6.325 and 6.95. This is how the WACC is calculated. 6.235, and here the WACC is a little bit higher, 6.95, in spite of the, you can see the difference.